Hey, everybody. Thanks for joining us for another installment of Anchors Away. I've got some very serious stuff to talk about today, and hopefully this will be a resource for you as we approach this time of year. This time of year, of course, is a severe weather season. I want to take a look at what's going to be on deck right now. Today, we're going to talk about severe weather, naturally. We're also going to talk about weather radios, a new campaign that's kicking off. Chief Meteorologist Keith Monahan is going to talk about that. Well, he's going to talk about all this stuff. And also, of course, weather safety, some things that you need to know. Regular panel joining us, Ashley Ketz, Mallory Brooks, and of course, Chief Meteorologist Keith Monahan. Guys, we're kind of talking about this too because of the things that we saw unfold in Alabama over the weekend, which was a devastating storm. And I think the last count, Mallory, was 23 people confirmed dead.
23 people confirmed dead, the last exact count. But at that time, officials said they expect that number to rise because right now search and rescue crews are underway trying to recover more people, which is so sad. And they do expect that number to rise. Yeah. It is devastating. You hear the stories of the children that were killed.
Six children.
Several elderly. It's just devastating. And the warning in that storm came so close to the actual tornado.
Well, you know, that happens. Tornadoes develop very, very quickly. Mm-hmm. People need to understand that when a tornado watch is issued, mm-hmm. they need to be ready to go at a moment's notice. Mm-hmm. Because there was a tornado watch in place. Right. This was not a surprise. It was a well-forecast weather event. Kind of like the event that we had a couple weekends ago, mm-hmm. where the severe weather was to our east. They had that big tornado in, I believe, Columbus, Mississippi. Mm-hmm. Well-forecast event. But it's actually your responsibility, the folks out there. If there's a tornado watch, you need to be ready.
When we start talking about these things, say on a Monday, and you're forecasting it perhaps for Friday, and some people say, "Well, we'll worry about it on Thursday night," that's not really the time to start worrying about it, right? When you start talking about it, start paying attention to it at least.
Well, we have to balance worry versus concern versus scare. We don't want to scare anybody, but we want people to at least be informed. Mm-hmm. So that's why we talk about these things so far in advance. It's not to get people to go into a panic. It's to make sure that you're not caught by surprise. And that's why we talk about these things so far out. Usually when we get within about 2 or 3 days of the actual event happening, we've got to pretty much nail down to what part of the country is going to be impacted. And then it's up to folks out there to stay on top of it with all the tools that are available.
And we try to do our job, whenever there's a tornado watch issued, we try to make sure it is at the beginning of the news, that you see it immediately, and then we mention it again in weather, of course, and again at the end of the newscast. But, we can only do so much, too.
Yeah, because that's when we let you guys take over. But let's do a little actual work, because we've got some potential for some weather. This is Wednesday.
This is Wednesday.
Potential for some weather this weekend.
Yeah, there is. Right now, the storm system, a pretty strong one, is going to be coming through Arkansas and the Mid-South as well. As the Gulf Coast states, probably late Friday night through the first half of Saturday. Again, it's coming at that time of day when the instability is lowest, so the risk is kind of mitigated somewhat. However, the storm's got a lot of energy, and it's going to be one of those situations where we have to watch it, because the storm system could actually perhaps overcome the time of day that it's coming through in. Normally, we don't expect to see widespread severe weather first thing in the morning. But a storm system this strong has a lot of potential, and we can hope that nothing happens, like last Saturday for us. But we need to be prepared just in case.
Of that preparedness, you're kicking off this week the new weather radio campaign. Tell us about this, because you've got some new partnerships.
And, we are so excited. We've been doing the weather radio campaign since I got got back here to Arkansas. That's the way I feel about it. Since I moved to Arkansas back in 2011, 2012, we were partnering with Walgreens for all those years. We are so proud and happy to be partnering with Kroger now. And we are going to be visiting seven different locations around the state. I don't think we've done that many before. I don't think anyone's done that many before. And they're not only going to be in central Arkansas. We're going to start off today, if you're watching on Wednesday, this evening, Wednesday night, the 6th of March, 4 to 7 p.m. at the Kroger on the Kroger Marketplace on Chenal. Then next week, we're going to be in Benton at the Kroger Marketplace on Interstate 30, that new one they built there. We have plans to go out to Brinkley, down to Hot Springs, out to Russellville, DeWitt, and Batesville. So we're trying to fan out across the whole state. Mm-hmm. I know we can't come to every town, because there's not a Kroger in every town. But at least my goal is to get us to those places that are centralized, where people from the outlying areas could come and either buy a weather radio or get their
Do you guys have weather radios?
I don't.
I do.
And I'll admit it. I'll be the first to admit it.
Shame on Ashley.
My husband was embarrassed when I did this, but on our wedding registry, I put a weather radio. You know, you're scanning
the
gun.
That's great.
I said, this is important. I want a weather radio. But, you know, it was just a basic one, probably came from Target. It isn't the one that we probably should get, which is
What is the weather radio? What's the good model of weather radio? Because there are a number of different ones on the market.
We partner with Midland, so, of course, I'm going to suggest a Midland weather radio. But that's most of what they do. It's not like a side business for Midland. They do weather radios and emergency communication radios. Mm-hmm. So this is their business. Mm-hmm. You want a radio that can be programmed for your county, because mm-hmm. Too many times those older ones, Mallory, they go off for everywhere.
Yes.
And people get annoyed by them,
and they shut them off.
So we can actually program them for a specific county. And that's as far as it goes. Can't do zip codes, but a specific county, and for the warnings you want to hear. I mean, we don't need to hear blizzard warnings in Arkansas.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, we had one. in 2012.
You know when that one's
first
coming.
First one ever. That's not going to be a surprise. But we could program it for whatever you need, whether you just want to, you know, have a tornado warning wake you up, or severe thunderstorm warning, or if you live in a flood-prone area, flash flood warning. So these radios are actually very customizable. And I think they're as important.
Actually,
as
that's what they look like.
Detector.
So take notes next time
that
you're in the store.
That is the actual model.
I need a visual.
I was going to have one, Bob. You know, we talked about it yesterday, but I actually programmed one for a viewer, and I had to mail it back.
That
to
was
her.
Really
oh,
sweet.
That's great.
So, and
so
that's
we'll do
what
those
I love about these events, and that you're mailing them off, is that Keith will stand there with you and find out where you live and what county you're in, and make it personalized for you. This is a personalized service that you're getting for free after you buy the radio, and it's wonderful.
That's great about
do.
These things. It's not just, you know, it's not just go pick up a radio. I mean, we're going to have weather service people there, a team of meteorologists. They're going to be there. You guys can answer questions, any weather-related question, whether it's,
That's right.
Do I have the right kind of storm shelter? Is my storm shelter in the right place? Where do I go in my house? What should I be looking for?
Yes.
Arkansas Department of Emergency Management going to join us at the Little Rock location, and we hope to have emergency managers from the different counties that we're going to, so we can have, like I mentioned last night in the news, a big brain trust of people that have all this knowledge that can answer your questions. So it's not just get a radio program to move along.
Bring your questions.
We'll sit there with you, and as you said yesterday, Bob, we will do free hugs.
Free hug.
And maybe a hug if you're lucky.
And maybe
I
a
love
hug.
That.
Make
You'll probably
make
get
you
a few of, I'm sure, your favorite questions that you get all the time. Mm-hmm. Like, my daughter is getting married in September.
Yes.
What is day?
We're going to need to know the forecast. Should we have the wedding inside or outside? I know you love those questions. I ask you those questions all the time,
Mallory.
Keith. I say, no, I'm sorry. But, you
can
know,
you just tell me about this, like,
we're
1 hour
go to an outdoor event?
10 days out. Is it going to rain?
What time is it going to rain? Some of the things that folks need to prepare, and I want this to be kind of a resource for people too, and you can share this link if we've got valuable information you think someone else might be able to use. But leading up to the storm, Keith, there are a number of ways, especially digital. I mean, we're big on digital.
Mm-hmm.
We want to know that folks can go to krk.com. Also, Facebook, our Facebook page, because if power goes out, you guys are still broadcasting on Facebook?
Yeah, and also, you know, Facebook Live came around and everybody went on Facebook Live, but if you have our app or you have a desktop or laptop, you know, directly now on the KRK page, we are pushing the streaming severe weather coverage. And a lot of times we'll do the coverage on the air, and when the immediate threat is over, of course, with a tornado warning, if the warning expires or is canceled, you know, we'll go back to regular programming, but we will continue in some instances if the storm is still very strong, streaming. And that way you can stay up to date, and we can get into a little bit more deeper discussions when we're streaming, because, you know, it's not as, you know, immediate danger as a tornado warning would be. You know, we can kind of go into more description of the storm and, you know, thoughts on where it's
going. Some of the stories too coming out of Alabama I saw, and boy, the folks out there just dealing with so much. But
it reminded me very much of Mayflower Valonia. The tornado was a similar strength. Mayflower Valonia was 190 miles per hour. This storm in Alabama was 170 miles per hour. 20 miles an hour not going to make too much of a difference. But it so reminded me of what we experienced and suffered here in Arkansas back in 2014.
Something that, you know, especially living in the South, and we're always told to have some kind of a plan, have an emergency weather plan. Some of the stories coming out of Alabama, I know that there were people that were injured in manufactured homes. And there was a story of one guy who rode the thing out in his truck. Not advisable.
No. Mm-mm. I mean, these 170 mile per hour winds. Mobile home, forget about it.
So people should have a plan.
You should have a plan. And again, that's pay attention. You know, you don't have to go into a panic, but if there's a tornado watch, then on that particular day, once that watch is issued, you might want to have a place to go that's a more substantial structure just for those hours. Tornado watches normally only last 5 to 6, 7 hours. Find a friend, a relative, somebody that has a more substantial structure, and just spend the afternoon there. This and that way you're not caught off guard, because if that warning comes out, again, you may only have a few minutes. You can't get in your car and drive away because you're putting yourself at even greater risk.
So it's one of those things. Be prepared, and of course, and ask questions too at these weather radio these weather radio stop-offs you guys have, because I've got a jillion questions, and I'm, you know, I've been working with you guys for years, and I'm always asking questions. And one thing was always very important to me. I would ask Keith, you know, do I need to move my family? You know, because for a while we lived in a manufactured home, mobile home, and I wanted to make sure they were okay. And he always said, this is what you need to do. And this is when you need to do it. So always keep yourself informed best as possible.
And we'll help you through all the tools, through our social media accounts, through our newscasts, through our webpage. We'll provide you those updates. Again, not to scare you, and don't want people to panic, but having that information helps you make informed choices.
Yeah. And now we, you know, and a storm shelter helps too. We live in a home now that's got an enormous storm shelter, so it's, you know, that safety is right there, fortunately, if you have that opportunity.
And those are taking place at Kroger.
They're going to be at
which
Kroger's.
I love. You can do your grocery shopping while you're there.
Right.
Knock out a whole lot of things.
We call it Weather Radio Wednesdays, and every location is going to be from 4 to 7 p.m. Like I said, Little Rock's today, Wednesday the 6th. Then we're going to be in the Kroger at Benton on the 13th. We're skipping a week because of spring break. And then we'll hit the Brinkley area, Hot Springs, Russellville, DeWitt, and Batesville. Of course, we'll remind you as we get closer to each of those events, but we really want people to come out, make sure their radios are working, make sure you can get one, you know, buy one if you need one, and answer your questions.
Because it's one of those things, it's not if, it's when.
We've been lucky past couple of years without any big storms. So
hate to say it, but.
One of those days it's gonna happen. Yes. We have not, I mean, if you look in history, there's only been one F5 tornado in Arkansas. With the Mayflower Valonia, I think that makes, you know, somewhere around 24 F4s, EF4s. But it just takes the one.
Yeah, exactly.
And an EF3 can do considerable damage as well. And any tornado can.
And if it's nighttime and you have no way to get any kind of warning, that's why this weather radio is so important. It's a good investment. It costs what? Around $40,
$30 to $40, depending on
But it's your life. You know, you're investing in safety.
And they last a while,
They don't last forever. I'll just tell you that up front. They last about 10 years because the thing is they're always on. They're always on standby. So, you know, but we've seen those radios last about 10 years, and I think that's for $3 a year, that's a pretty darn good investment.
Yes.
It's cheaper than a lot of apps on your phone.
Yeah.
And this thing, you know, the National Weather Service has those radio stations around the state. That broadcasts on a special frequency that go to these special radios. That's what they're for. That's all those radios do, is they listen for the warnings.
It's a great, another line of defense to have to keep you and your family safe. All right, guys, thanks very much. Appreciate
Thank you, Bob.
Keith, I know you got to hit the road. Thank
you heading out to Kroger now.
You can also check us out at krk.com. Pardon me, for all this information. And, of course, you can check back in next week for another installment of Anchors Away. Thanks very much. Have a great week, everybody.